And as we breathe the air with these enthusiastic Sagittarian energies, we turn our attention to our hearts, to the hearts of our hearts, to the Holy of Holies in our centers, where abides an eternal spark. This spark is the tip of the magic wand we all had as children. Remember? This spark is made joy. Joy that comes from the experience and realization of the oneness. This so tiny yet vibrant spark is a part of the flame of the universe, of everything that exists, and therefore connects us. Our consciousness is connected to everything that is. Its radiance flows through our systems, our minds, our emotions, our etheric and physical bodies, transforming everything that we are into a big smile. Everything that we are smiles, yes. And then goes and radiates beyond into our immediate environment and further, connecting us, each of us, our hearts, heart to heart, mind to mind, soul to soul. Into this sphere of light of love surrounding our beautiful planet. In which center is our group's heart. Itself open to the hierarchy and to Shambhala. And we will finish this short alignment with a quote from A Course in Miracles. With nothing in our hands to which we cling, with lifted hearts and listening minds, we hear a single voice which speaks of truth. Salvation covers us with soft protection and peace so deep that no illusion can disturb our mind nor offer proof that it is real. In this moment, separation ends, and we remember who we really are. Let's light our candles and begin our work in our gathering together.
Thank you, Daniela, and welcome to everyone. And I would welcome, we're in the middle of a windstorm, so we'll just cross fingers that things go well for all of us. It would be really lovely to see all of your faces, particularly during the presentations. It's really nice to be able to speak to people. I understand if you can't be online visual, that's great, that's okay. But for this time, if you are willing, we would love to see your faces. And we're all kind of on one screen right here, so that would be awesome. Welcome to Solstice, Full Moon, end of the year, and a couple of housekeeping things for today. We'll be following our same format, but what is true now, meditation, and what's the next right step. This one, we will be, after the meditation, we'll be going into small breakout rooms. And we'll have one or two questions for the breakout rooms to consider. And we'll ask the breakout rooms to consider one of the questions. This will give us all an opportunity to speak, because I think the conversation really needs it. And at the end of the breakout rooms, when we come back, we would ask one of the people in the room to bring back one sentence, one idea. There may be 15 great ideas and conversation pieces in that, but we'd ask you to bring back one that really sticks out for you to share in the larger group. The other part of today is that you may have noticed, of course you read all of the emails and you've got all the timing down pat, that we've extended today's session because of the breakout rooms for another 15 minutes or so, if you are able to stay. This just allows us to have a richer conversation. We'll give that an attempt, a try. And the other piece today is that, would you just keep in mind that in our conversation with Lisa and Anastasia, before this, it looked like there might be a lot to say. And so at the end of today, we'll ask whether you would like to continue this conversation on Sunday at the same time in a second part. We have no attachment to it, but there may be more to say. And so just keep those things back in my mind. I'll come back to them but before the end of the day. So Lisa comes back to us from Scorpio. She has wrestled the Hydra into the ground or into the light. And she is now here to connect us to Sagittarius. She's in the U.S. And we welcome Anastasia Smirnova from Russia. She's currently in Cyprus. Are you right now?
Cyprus.
Awesome. And she brings a whole other perspective. And this really, in our group conversation, really opened things up. So I'm not sure who's going first. Is Lisa going first?
Lisa.
Okay.
Lisa.
So you've got about 5 minutes for each. Get your thinking caps on. And then you guys can talk after we've had that.
Well, first of all, what a beautiful picture, music, meditation. Thank you so much. It really helped me enter the field. So as probably a lot of you already know, if you've read The Labors of Hercules, the goal of Sagittarius is to cause the Stymphalian birds to scatter due to the positive sounds of hope and vision that we give instead. We don't kill the birds through our arrows trying to shoot at them, which to me is like trying to argue with somebody. Instead, we clang the cymbals. We sound a sound that is so fulfilling, fills the room, or significant that it calls the attention to that. And so for me, as I look out at the world, it feels like it could be difficult to get through that noise of so much greed and cynicism and fear and anger and negativity and dystopian despair, to name a few birds here. And so as we attempt to rise above this and sound that kind of, you know, we do Merry Christmas, ho, ho, ho here in the United States, which can seem in a way like a spiritual bypass. For many people, this is not a very happy holiday. And so the task is for me, how do we sound the symbols, that higher sound of hope and optimism and the new vision without a spiritual bypass, which in psychological language means that we ignore the pain and the fear and just try and make everything rosy and bright without really acknowledging where people are at. So how do we meet people where they are at and give them our empathy and concern and yet sound the note of that hope and that vision so we can get to the other side of remembering the joy as Daniela said, and the reality of who we are so that our souls can prevail. And then I want to emphasize something that I read in the last two pages of Externalization of the Hierarchy regarding the vision, since we're in the month of vision, that the Tibetan himself left for us. He closed the book emphasizing these two things need to be accomplished before 2025. One is the defeat of totalitarianism, which is the imposition of ideas by the few onto the many anywhere. And two is establishing the kingdom of God through love and goodwill so the hierarchy can appear. And I encourage you to read those few paragraphs in full for yourselves. And so the urgent question that I am going to propose and put in the chat room for us to explore is, how do we accomplish this? The defeat of totalitarianism and establishing the kingdom of God. And how can we rally within ourselves and others the faith, hope, love, courage, and goodwill so that we can hear those higher sounds emerge? And I will put those in the chat room for the groups to use in their discussion. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay, just take a breath and move to Anastasia and see where we go from there. Thank you, Lisa.
I think it's very beautiful to intertwine our theme and my theme with Lisa. Hi to everyone, my name is Anastasia. And my specific idea for this invitation of Alexander was, I spoke recently with a government man in Russian government, and he said like the government of Russia has a huge crisis, because most of the people in the government, like 60 and more. And the problem not with the age, the problem is that the ideas that they had are very, very strict, regulated. They're not flexible, they're not opened. And very few young people are going in because they have a specific ideas how to break person to make him like the system. And the good people don't go there, and not good people not need there. So less and less and less and less people go there. And in like 10 years, we will have like major problem because we don't have enough people in the government system that includes like hundreds of thousands of people, because I'm talking not about like a president thing, but like the whole government system, like to the like many, 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 many levels. And it's approximately in Russia, 100 to 150,000 of people, because it's all the stages. So my idea was to meditate for the government of Russia, government of states, to open them to higher energy so they will see new ideas, see new goals, and start to prepare them to the 2025 that actually, you know, like will go much more smoothly than like, okay guys, now it's 2025, are you ready? No, haha. So my idea was to actually starting invite the energies of hierarchy and the higher energies, so that crisis will actually go the right way. Not into the, you know, like system try to survive and try to make stronger, make it like more strict, make it more like closed, and actually make more alive, more open, because crisis is an opportunity. And I really would like to be this opportunity to be a good one, because if I open the history book, like textbook of history, it will be like revolution, like depression, like low quality of life, like shoo, and minus 50 years and minus like best men and women. And we tried to recover that like next change, next blood sacrifice actually. So I think we are here to do it the other way. And we really need it because in Russia it's like going to totalitarianism like really quickly. And it's not cool. And in Russia, Russian people are very an initiative. You understand? Like, do not have a lot of initiative. And we always against the government, like people against the government against the people, like for last 1,000 years. I'm not kidding, like 1,150 years. So I think 2025 is actually a good moment to be together, to start to be together, to overcome this this idea. And my question for you in small groups will be like very, very close to what Lisa said, but just a little slightly different angle, as I can say it, is what ideas or actions can help us to bring these changes without like a lot of blood and sacrifice to make like this future be, and us as a society be more open and more human to each other without like really, really, really a lot of disaster. Thank you.
Okay, I want to add one little bit of peace in here before I let you two loose to go back and forth. And that, I'm going back to Lisa's talking about the symbols. I work with music and its effect on form. Symbols, when we play them, do not produce nice harmonic sounds. You know, you do not want to be in a room of cymbal players. But if you go into the Buddhist tradition, if you go into any place where there is that symbol, symbols create dissonant harmonies. And those dissonances, you can do this with tuning forks or close with two people singing closely together. Dissonances break up fixed form. And I'll leave that there and let the two of you go for a few minutes.
Well, and for me, the dissonance is getting people to understand how to get through fear. I mean, totalitarianism is trying to take over the United States, and we really only have about 6 months between now and May, which is Waysak, Taurus, the bullseye. Sagittarius is trying to hit the bullseye. Those of us that live in the United States know that the same tactics that have been used in other countries to create totalitarianism, the dictator's playbook, is being used here. And I think it relies upon us forgetting who we are spiritually. Helplessness is something that the personality does primarily, ultimately, because of the fear of death. And I'm not saying that if I were to really have to face the fear of death, I would be able to just go, yes, I'm not Ray 1, I'm Ray 2. You know, yes, I'm really ready to face the fear of death. But, and I'm not saying that I want us to go into blood and sacrifice for it. But I notice even in myself, if I'm real, when I hear the news every day, the birds, what's going on here in this country, I can feel that little personality in me wanting to just kind of figure out, well, how can I hide out in my home here? So, you know, I don't have to deal with this. And the symbols for me are the clanging that has to happen inside my own personality to say, stop that, get off that. You know, the courage, the love, you know, do I really care about humanity or not? This is the test. And so I feel that I haven't really overcome all those Hydra heads inside myself, but it's up, and it's up now, and it's up in the next 6 months, not really until 2025. For some reason in the United States, it's like they know they have to get this totalitarianism done before 2024. And they're fighting very hard to do it within the next 6 months. And I have got to have the symbols clang in me so that I will do everything I can to let the kingdom of God, Goddess, Spirit appear.
I it's really, really beautiful. And I think, yes, we actually don't have ideas how to act in stressful things, I mean, besides violence. So we actually don't have the textbook. Okay, bad things happen, so I should do 1, 2, 3 and stop these things. So I truly believe we need some guidance, I mean, how to be a good person and how actually bravely do the right things. Because it mostly mixed together. So for me, it's a beautiful, it's beautiful that we have time, we have understanding what is happening, and we are not helpless because there's like billions and billions and billions of us, and we are connected, and we are like, can share the ideas now, and you probably cannot stop it unless you like switch the whole electric system in the world. So that's lovely. So yeah, but we can see the China and the process that happens there and how they like create the world for the people and how they built it. So I understand how they can make it in Russia. I personally don't have any idea how they will do it in the States, but probably you have. So I really understand that we need to be more initiative and brave. Yes, brave.
You're reminding me suddenly of, there's this show that we watch as kids every year in the United States called How the Grinch Stole Christmas. And the interesting thing about that, it's almost like a Sagittarius story. You know, the Grinch is a materialist and he can't stand all the noise that the Whos down in Whoville make as they get ready for Christmas. So he's going to wipe out Christmas by taking away all their materialistic presents. And then he sits there in glee waiting to see the boo-hoo-hoos that they're going to start sounding now. And they don't. They come out with nothing. Everything's been destroyed. He's destroyed it. And they hold hands and they sing. And he realizes maybe Christmas is a little bit more than all this materialistic paradigm that even here in the United States, it's, you know, what they sell us constantly. It's about stuff, stuff, stuff. And when all of that is gone, all of us can join on this Zoom and we can hold hands and we can sing because we know who we are. With that Christ spirit. So you reminded me of that. Thank you so much. It's really touched me.
Is there a song that is known by everybody, not only those who know?
I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. There is one. Happy New Year. Yeah.
I remember thinking in terms of the song that the earth apparently hums, or the universe hums on the note of B flat. And I was thinking how wonderful it would be if everybody who knows that could go out into the like their garden or onto their balcony every morning sing the note B flat as a mantra to the universe, to the earth, to each other, to the community. To nature, and how that would help harmonize. Surely it would create that sort of energetic resonance between us. Put that out there as a possibility.
I know we're going to go into our breakouts, but like what's going through me is like, wouldn't it be great to have like a world song, and maybe we sing our different songs from different countries, or we sing one song, I don't know, but just something to just say we know who we are. And it isn't this story you keep trying to sell us, and the songs represent who we really are in our spirit.
I think in a way what Anastasia suggested, it's about that tuning into that new song that we all can hear through our own meditation, because when as we meditate we listen to own soul. And in the soul, on the soul level, we are all one. So that's where that note comes through. And so I truly believe that people who work in the governments around the world, they're not bad people. they just don't have fresh ideas, as Anastasia said. They just crystallized in very tough thought forms, and many of them, they want to do the right thing. But you have only certain patterns that you can follow. But if we as esoteric meditators and the world service in general can start meditating the new ideas into the mental field of humanity, that would be like a lifeline for all those good people who want to do right things, and that would be big support for them. That would be the common song to sing, bringing the new ideas.
Just want to remind everyone that's here, you're welcome to unmute. We've got a small group. This is a conversation. So if you have something to say, unmute or put your hand up or put something in the chat. I know my brain is going back and forth on a few things, but anyway, that's just want to remind you of that.
Okay, I will have to change the settings that people would be able to unmute themselves. So now,
that's why nobody's speaking, because you're muted. You're muted, everybody.
Well, there is the chat. Anymore. So, Lisa and Anastasia, could you talk about the challenge of complacency?
Can you rephrase the word complacency?
Being complacent, being so what Lisa was saying, when you hear the noise out there, I just want to go and retreat into my house and ignore everything else. So many times we hear, just turn the news off. Don't participate. Turn the news off. Don't listen. Don't get involved. But there seems to be that level of complacency of saying, okay, it'll all take care of itself.
Yes, I think I have like Russian perspective, so I can understand that Russian is very, very passive, like generally. If we can lie down, whine a little bit and do nothing, we'll do that peacefully. And like people should really, 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 really piss us, so we are like stand up and do something. And it's all in our folklore, all in our like fairy tales. It's like in fairy tales, it's there. So I understand that thing that will stop the complacency, it's initiative, and the people are like interested in their life, and they're like going through the noise, like Lisa said. I mean, it's when you are like not, how to say, you're not confronting the ideas, because basically it's hard and it's useless, but you live your life through that, like you're going through the stream. And for me, it's the way how to break it, because you are not fighting with this, because you just make it bigger, and you are not ignoring it, that makes you like helpless. You just do your life through this and make your own ideas, make your own vision. So yeah, for me, it's like this. It's like, it's what Russia needs more. So they're not like looking like against like vaccination good, vaccination bad, vaccination good, vaccination bad. You still think about vaccination. You don't think about like to clean your garden or to make peace with your relatives. So yeah.
I think for me, it's interesting being in the United States, because I think our vision is consumption. Consume is a solution to everything, stuff. And what I kind of like about Donald Trump and what he's doing to our country is he's got everything. And he doesn't look real happy to me. It's like, if bliss and happiness is the vision we're really trying to bring to people, is that really what's happening with consumption as our vision? And so it's like wonderful in a way to have the antithesis of this, that maybe there's another vision we can start to give people, especially we just had this horrible tornado. I mean, you can't infrastructure your way out of a tornado like the one we just had here. Went 240 miles over four states. and it took steel buildings and shredded them into toothpicks. So Mother Nature has her sound of symbols that she's sending here, that we have to come up with something. I can only speak for my country at the moment, besides this vision of capitalism as consumption. And somehow or another, that's what I know will rally me forward, is a group of people whose vision I can align myself with.
Yeah, Alain. Voila, vas-y.
Yes, thank you. For me, what aggravates the risk of extreme individualism. And consumption is based on extreme individualism. So the crisis that we face, be it the climate crisis, the racial crisis, the inequality crisis, and the democratic crisis are somewhat linked to the fact that we've been encultured for 100 years at least in a very extreme individualism. What counts is me. And so the capacity to go to more of a unity consciousness and be, yes, we each have our own gifts and talents and needs, but how can we go beyond that and seeing that the solutions will only come through the ability to not think just of oneself, but others, and especially if they are different from us. So for me, all the tyrants in history have always asserted their power when people were extremely divided, including within themselves. I just wanted to throw that in, is that if we don't find a way, and there is some people say we are now benefiting from a new wave of consciousness. They call it the ninth wave of consciousness, which is unity consciousness, versus the last wave, which was extremely individualist. So how can we manifest in the way we live and the way we serve, the fact that we are beginning to resonate with that ninth wave, with that new wave that invites us to be aware of the whole and to be in the we rather than the I. So that's why I wanted to add.
Alain, that, were you here when Brother Philip was here during Libra? He spoke about the only real issue. He was talking about colonialism, indigenous, non-indigenous, right? And the bottom line issue was the great heresy of separativeness.
Yes.
And seeing other, whether yes. It's indigenous, non-indigenous, Russian, US, thus, them. It's that was the key.
Very much.
That has stuck with me for the past few months.
I will add to that, I just read the article. It's about states and Russia, because obviously it was a good idea to make a, it always catch the attention. So they won't take like Sweden and states, no. They will take Russian and US citizens, so. But there is very sad research that for the last 20 years, the number of friends of like every person that they checked, like decrease in four times. So four times less friends than 20 years ago. And every fifth person that they asked said, like they was asking only adults, like after 30, said they have no friends at all. At their own point, they didn't have friends at all. I mean, like the people who they consider friends, not like, comrades or buddies, but real friends. And I think it is a thing that we really need to meditate on so we can create this real bonds between people that they can rely on. Yes, because friends as a group members, as a family, it's the place that our hearts opens and our like individualism like stops in friendship. Because in love, we're a little bit driven by instincts or by passion. But in friendship, we are really, really humans. So I think the thing that we should like sing, it's about the friendship as well, because it's about this things that stops the pure individualism, as I can see it.
I wanted to highlight one more thing, and it's something that you said. Anastasia, is that it? How you say it?
Anastasia.
And, you know, the average age of almost 8 billion people around the world is 40. And in most countries, it's 30. And even in my country, it's like, why are all these 70 and 80 year olds the ones in power? I mean, I'm getting up there myself, so I do honor and respect wisdom. But when most of the world has all this dynamic, youthful energy, ideas, probably new unity consciousness embedded more within them, how do we free that up so that they're not feeling lonely or isolated, that they know who they are because they are the future? And they are probably, most of them, confused because they're much more evolved than the, God bless them, 70, 80-year-olds trying to keep them down. How do we free them up? So that just came to me as well.
Hello.
As an elder, I'm 82. So I think what is happening is actually elders should not be called elders. It should be called older people for most of them. There's a difference in traditional societies, as you know, between elders and people who are aged. And elders who retire also from participation in life. I mean, some of them are grandparents, etc. But what I'm part of a movement called the Elders Action Network, and we are trying to we are in the process of inventing a new process called the regenerative elder process. How do you start, how do you continue growing and participating and serving while being an elder? Yes, I agree with you. They dominate most of the political hierarchies, including China, probably Europe, and this country as well. But they have succumbed themselves to a form of individualism that instead of serving, like most elders in traditional society used to do, they were bringing up children, they were serving the community. They're not serve anymore. And when they're still in public service, then they're mostly serving themselves, with a few exceptions. So I think this is part of the evolution we are trying to see, is that, is there a rite of passage to become an elder that transform us into people who, while working with younger generations, actually regenerate ourselves and promote values that are very different from the majority of the values at this time. So it's a tall order, but I'm working on it.
I just put the link in the chat for those who want to go and check that out. Thank you, Alain. That's great.
You're welcome.
Let's just take a breath. And if we actually physically do this, this is a Qigong, we can just release. Do that again. You can feel that we let it go. And once more, because you haven't done this too often. And notice what your body does. Anybody else get little tinglies in their body? Just let it go. That's a great way to end something, to bring it to a close, to release. You can do that in your office. You don't even have to, or wherever. You can do it at a dinner party when you can't stand the conversation. You can do it quietly. Just visualize that feeling and you can release anything that way. I'm going to give you a moment of music, invite you to just be silent and let things reflect. And then Anastasia, once I've finished, I invite you to take the meditation. And so just once more, Lisa and Anastasia, could you put in the chat the questions you'll want, just so, because we've had a few new people come in. Put those in the chat as best you can, and we'll come back to that. And if you'd like to turn your video off, that would be okay, as we do a little bit of music and meditation. So just find your body. If you would all hum this in your own space, take a breath. Humming to ah opens the heart.
Let's take deep breathing, breathe out. Please visualize us standing in a circle of light. And in the center of the group, put the images of your government structure, and within this structure, people of goodwill, under the big, big pressure on the very, very high weight. And very few light there, very few sound, very few changes, very, very few fresh air, and no feeling that you are supported, no feeling that you have connection. And sometimes no feeling that you do the right thing. And let's make a triangles of the people of goodwill and then connect to these good people in our governments. And through these triangles, let's send the higher energies, the new ideas, the things that we bring from our sharing about friendship, about consuming, about initiative. And let's make them feel that they are not alone, and there is ideas and hope and good changes. And we should see the May and put this energy from here to the May. So these people will be supported and can do more for us and we for them. And the second step is all this crisis around the world, we embrace it because crisis is a place for a change. And we put a sign or idea to move forward, to be more open, more brave, more friendly, and more alive and young, doesn't matter of your age. And we put this idea and direction for this movement through this crisis. So we're not going to more isolation and more fear. We're going to more braveness through the fear and more openness and friendship and taking care of each other. Doesn't matter of your nationality, color of your skin, and gender and age. And we're moving these ideas through the crisis till May of 2025-22 and forward to 2025. And open our group centers to the hierarchy and Shambhala so they can guide us and the humanity. And we all together sing three times Om. Om. And we let go of the meditation. We open our minds, our eyes, our hearts, and join together here.
Thank you, Anastasia. Okay, so I can see Alexander is hard at work at creating breakout rooms for you to choose to go to. And in a moment, we'll have those open for you. So we invite you to choose the room you want to go to. And Lisa, and would you all just in the chat, would you all just take a look at the questions that Lisa and Anastasia have put in? Either write them down or copy them for, or just get the sense of where we're going.
If someone native speaker can modify my writing into the something like grammatically right, I would be really appreciated. Because I don't have to put it like into the spelling. So
what you've done is great. It's completely comprehensible. Yeah, very good. And so we will give, let me just check time here. Where are we? Great. Okay. Sasha, are we changing up to do the Lisa and Anastasia speak first and then into breakouts?
Yes. So that's, and before going into the breakout rooms, yes.
Okay. So let me just, sorry, I didn't have that quite in my head. So just before we go into breakouts, Lisa and Anastasia, so our next section is what's the next right step? And so for each of you, if you've got a few minutes to say where you see this is going, and that will give us food for the breakouts. And by then, Sasha will have the breakouts. So what is the next right step, Lisa and Anastasia?
Lisa first.
Couldn't find out how to unmute myself. So for me, I think it's going to be to continue to do some deeper meditation and to try and get a better understanding of group vision, which is one of the reasons I'm looking forward to ideas that come forward out of the breakout rooms.
For me, the next step would be, as I can say it, in next week, I will have a lot of webinars that will affect like a few thousand people in Russia and the Russian-speaking community all over the world. So I will try to sound for the themes that they are interested in, like relationship and the future, this note of courage and friendship and hope and feeling that they are like can create their own destiny and they're not alone. So my next step would be to sing these notes from my actual words and to encourage them to be who they can be and be more fearless, I guess, and more brave and independent on what they see around, something like this.
And I suppose this is extremely practical. Thank you. And so I suppose for each of us, there is some very practical thing we might also set up for ourselves to do over the next little while. At least we're always looking for something practical, because it's always, you know, it's one thing to stay in the esoteric mental, high mental, but it's something else to walk out in the world and act. All right. Anything else from anybody else before we go into breakouts? Okay. And just to remind, yeah, Catherine. Hi, dear.
I just wanted to say, hey, y'all. And I'm so appreciating the generosity of the leaders and facilitators. And it's not easy to get people talking. Once you've been the organizer, then everybody assumes you're going to do the talking. So thank you for seeding the group with your beautiful intentions and organization. It's deeply appreciated.
Thank you. Beautiful. And so before we go into groups, thank you all. We will be back. And just keep in mind, we will be coming back to ask you if you want to continue this conversation on the 19th. It will be a group decision, and we'll come back to that. So, Sasha, drum roll.
So we'll have four groups now, and each group, there will be one from our coordination group to help to organize and keep the timing. And so now I will press the magic button, and you will have to accept to be redirected to the breakout room.
And just if you are unsure what to do, stay here and Sasha will put you in the room, and Claire.
And Alexander, just a question about how much time we'll have in our breakout group so that the group has an idea of...
Since I'm going to be Saturn.
How long we can set for.
15 yeah. Minutes. No, we've got a little more. We have 17 or 18 minutes.
And then we're coming back into the main group.
And then you'll get a message. So I will send a message to Sasha. We'll send a message to the groups. And so we'll be at about 20 past. All right. And just a reminder, we want one statement from one person in the group when we come back. Okay, Sasha, go.
So please accept the invitation to be redirected to your group. So there, Daniel, Gloria, Yoke, please accept invitation to go to a group. Daniel, Yoke, please accept invitation to go to a group. Yoke not speaking English. Just press yes. Yoke. You will be in the group with Anastasia, I believe. Daniel, please. Accept invitation to go to a group.
so much fun to see everybody just, I don't know, some of you will remember, if you're American, will remember the TV show Bewitched, you know, when she would wiggle her nose and things would happen. Get a thumbs up. Was that helpful for those of you coming back in? Yeah. Okay. So I think we're kind of all here. Let me just, here we go. Okay. Sorry, I have a kitten here whose current name is Velcro because she's just kind of stuck to me. Anybody want a kitten? She needs to find a home that I already have. Ah, a few. Can you just hit a thumbs up in your screens if that was interesting and helpful? Did that work for you? Okay. All right. So can we go around to each of the rooms? And room one, who is, you know, the person who is representing that room? I know it's JR in our group. It's going to come out and say the one point. The one point. JR, room one.
Okay, our one point from room one was we need to do the work within ourselves so we can meet others from a point of commonality.
Take that in. Room two.
Be motivated to connect with goodwill in order to build friendships with the intention of listening to hear the soul of each other, and to connect all of us on the soul level, thereby building the group Antakarana.
Say that once more, please.
And I put it in the chat.
Put it in the chat. But just for some people, they might not have access. Can you say that once more?
Be motivated to connect with goodwill in order to build friendships with the intention of listening to hear the soul of each other and connect on the soul level to build the group Antakarana. We kind of cheated. We blended a lot of ideas together.
One really big sentence. I think it did it nicely. Very nice. Thank you, Lisa. Room three.
And we hadn't, but maybe some, I don't know, Catherine or Tina, maybe you'll say something. I'm sorry, bad host. Got very.
With Tina in there, yeah. Tina, what's one idea that you took from that group?
How to develop a different point of view and create sense of responsibility.
Anybody seeing a theme running through this? Okay, room four.
Thank you.
I'm not sure which room we were.
You're up now, Alan.
But I'm up. So. I think the common denominator was being in our heart, in our own vulnerability, in our own humanness, so we can sense the humanness of the other person. And there's a bridge between being in the heart and having courage. They are very connected.
Take that in. Room five, did we have a fifth?
No, we had only four rooms.
Four rooms. Any other pressing ideas that didn't get shared? Okay. So Lisa and Anastasia, some closing thoughts, practices? I'm just before we do that, it just occurs to me, all the time, that from just what we shared in the group, that as we go into the next few weeks in towards January, there may be a personal practice that we can develop for ourselves from these. Make sense? There's a personal attentive, if we can practice and be attentive to one particular thing, finding whatever the listening is, that might be a possibility. So Lisa and Anastasia, thoughts?
Well, I'll borrow from Daniela in our group, and it's something that's already happening to me here. I was really honored to hear from some of the people in my group that I didn't know. Just this idea of connecting with each other more. And Daniela, I forgot what I was going to say that you said. It inspired me. But, that's what you said. So that when we're faced with something, we can take the group with us. These aren't her exact words, but my sense of it, that we remember that we're not alone, that we are building this inner connection with each other, and that we do have each other, and we have the hierarchy on the inner planes as well.
As my thought or my personal practice for the next several weeks, I would take something that when we can see the future that we are really like, we can be very productive. And we can be super productive, but we can actually see the future that we don't like. So between these two futures, we can make our courage, we can find the friends, we can build a group, and we can go through the future that we don't like to the future that we really like, that we can build. Yes, so that's what I will show the people that are around me. So, okay, listen, guys, we have like really, really bad futures coming on us, and we really need like the better future that we can build through the friendship, courage, initiative, and friendship.
Any other thoughts from anyone? Yeah, Stacia.
Just for me, it's helping to seek, and sometimes it's a challenge to find, but seek the similarities between myself and another, no matter how oppositional the other may be with me. I can always find a strand of something that I can grasp that's similar.
Alexander.
Very resonated with what Anastasia said. It's the words taking care of each other. I think that's the key for the new civilization, which is like Aquarian civilization is civilization of brotherhood. And no matter how we love or hate each other within the family, we still care of each other. So that's an important note to hold for the vision.
If you think about troops that are in war, and the medics, any medics anywhere in any kind of disaster, politics doesn't matter. Nationality doesn't matter. You know, if a Taliban came to an American soldier, to a medic, they were taken care of, period. They're human beings. That always sticks with me. Alain, then Catherine.
Yes, I would. I keep in mind what Thomas Hubel says about the two. He calls them superpowers that we have is to be fully present in any encounter, as free as we can be from the traumas we have experienced in our lives, to be as present as possible and to be as relational as possible, to be aware. You know, I'm seeing you seeing me. That's the kind of thing, it's to be so attentive to what is in the moment and across the relation, and letting go of many other things that could come to our mind. It's so, again, it reinforces being centered in the heart and in the body as well. Yeah,
that's connected to literally what is true now, what is actually
what true is true now. Absolutely. Yeah.
Catherine, thank you. Alain.
I'm so appreciating what he said. that I'm asking myself how to do this as a beginning rather than as a concluding note. But I think what was coming to me was, again, it's the way my mind works, that there are things we all need: food, water, pure air. You know, it's not like some humans need water and some humans don't. We all have those needs. And then other things become, you know, more individuated. And so as we begin to contemplate, like, what are the things we all need? And then what are the things that we uniquely need? Then we can really be skillful in the way we take care of each other.
We all need to be loved and know that we matter. Stacia.
Real quick, I just had a recent assignment to review golden verses of Pythagoras. And one of the golden verses of the Stoic is, "But take courage, the race of man is divine."
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so one of the needs that, you know, we would go first for something that sustains our physical existence immediately, but it's the divinity that sustain us within us, shared divinity, that is also extremely important, and connection with that essence, our own essence within our shared essence. Yeah. Need. Important.
Claire, you had something? You okay?
No, I was just going to say, what a beautiful synthesis, you know, with all these ideas coming together, it's just this beautiful weaving. Mm-hmm. Mm. Thank you.
Okay. Well, I think I know the answer to the question, but I'm going to ask anyway. Is there a need, interest, desire, calling to have a meeting on Sunday? If you think this would be helpful, and if you want to continue this, would you just like raise your hand either digitally or physically? I knew it. Okay. So when Lisa and Anastasia and our organizing group had the first conversation, I was thinking, this is just going to keep on going. But it feels to me also like that we have a complete piece here. Yes? You have your marching orders for the next month?
We are complete.
We are complete. All right. Alexander, Sasha, over to you, my dear.
I completely blank in what I have to do. I know we still have a like very beautiful musical piece, Lisa, if you still want to play it.
Mm-hmm.
I remember that Sharon called me to make announcements. So Lisa, I don't know, like, I can say just a few words about our coming meetings. Yes. This full moon, and then would be over to you to share your video. Do you want to do that?
Sure. Am I going to play it and share my screen then?
Yes, you can share your screen.
And did you want me to share the whole 5 minutes or go to the last two? The whole 5 minutes?
Probably last two. Yeah.
Two? Okay.
Yeah. And then we'll come back. And Daniela, are you closing today? Who's doing? I don't have
Claire. I think Claire.
Claire is going to close us up. Okay. Wonderful. Okay, Sasha, Lisa, Claire.
So we today is the first of 5 days of the full moon, and I'm sure each of us has many meetings planned for this 5 days. It's full moon, it's solstice. So no matter which meeting we will attend, it's the sense of the group and our togetherness. That's what is important during these 5 days. And if you open. Please join us. We have almost every day something's happening. First of all, we have our vigil continuing every day at 9 p.m. Greenwich Meridian time, which is in 25 minutes from now. And tomorrow we'll have an open forum for vigil participants. It will be open sharing and reflection on the unfolding purpose of our common work, not just the vigil work, but what we as a terrorists see and unfolding for us. It will be happening tomorrow at 7:30 GMT. And then on the 20th, the day before solstice, we have the meditation for the common good. And we will come together open to the new cycle of Capricorn. And the topic for the new month is the higher purpose, linking with the higher purpose, and how we keep that linkage as we see the new foundations for the new civilization emerge. So that's our topic for the next whole month. So please come. Helen from London will be leading us in meditation. And on 21st, the day of solstice, we have the creative lab with the Hekal group and Klangshali group. That's will be our continuous series on the souls of our nations. I'm sure I forgot something, but the main thing that we all linking our different meetings into one ongoing meeting. It's our weaving.
And if you have any questions, just contact Sasha. He'll be happy to let you all know. All right, thank you, Lisa and Anastasia. Before we go, thank you all so much. Can we all just do this for them? Oh. Thanks. And we wish you were going to send this over to Lisa for some music, and we wish you all a wonderful solstice, Christmas, Kwanzaa, whatever you are going to celebrate. May the arrows that you shoot over the next year reach their goal. And, thank you all, and we'll see you in Capricorn. And Lisa, Sasha, did you have something else?
Yes, this is like directed to Lisa. Lisa, when you will be sharing your screen now, please make sure to have advanced audio sharings. Do you know how to do it?
I see it.
She just needs to have a computer sound.
It says multiple participants can share screen, one participant. When I click on that, that's all I see.
Maybe if you can give, put the link to the video in the chat, I can play from my computer.
I'd be happy to do that. Just a second. Yeah. I will go into it.
See how easy all this has become in the past couple of years.
Okay, hang on. You're going to have to go through a commercial, it looks like. Just a second. I'll do it in the chat. And while he's getting that ready, this is from Yanni, and it's his song Santorini. And the reason I picked it, and this one is live in front of Egypt, is that he is, to me, the song starts with, like, in my mind, a cacophony of birds, and then it like escalates into more and more of a joyous sound. And there's like trumpets and cymbals, and at the end there's applause. And to me, it just sounds very Sagittarian, very joyful, very uplifting. And Sasha, I think it was around 2 minutes left. We'll probably cut into something, but it'll still work. I hope you all enjoy it and are uplifted by it.
And I hope I will be doing it right. So can you see my screen?
No, you need to optimize video clip and share computer sound. And
I'm sharing computer
you're just
sound.
Sharing computer sound, you're not sharing your screen.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Great.
I hope the sound will be awesome and optimized.
This one's for you.
So 2 minutes you said in, Lisa?
No, about 2 minutes left. So how many is in it total?
Mm-hmm.
I'll just go there. What the heck?
Sorry.
You have the link in the chat if you want to go listen to it yourselves. Thank you.
Beautiful, Lisa. Thank you. And gosh, what a setting. What an incredible setting. And all those fireworks reminds me of us, you know, always this image of us as a constellation and just how perfect it is really in the light of this evening's conversation or today's conversation, you know, that we are exactly in the right place. Each and every one of us, politically, geographically, it's so right that we are where we are in our different places around the globe. So thank you for a very robust and spontaneous and loving conversation today. And yeah, just been very special and everyone's been so present and fully participatory. So our experiment went well today, I'd say. So yeah, we want to wish you all a very blessed Christmas, and some of you will see before Christmas, I guess, on online platforms, but we might go out today with Pentatronix's Mary song and wishes for a very blessed, safe and joyful Advent season. Thank you all. Thank you, Anastasia. Thank you, Lisa. And thank you, everyone. I'll share my screen. And as Rumi says, beyond right and wrong, there is a field. We'll meet each other there. And hopefully I can make this work.
Walk on water. Mary, did you know that that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Blessings, everyone. Go well.
Okay, we will see you in the next. In the ethers and in our next month, we'll be closing the gates in just a few seconds. So you can gather up your things and carry on. Bye, everyone.